Blood test would just indicate that you could be the father. I'm sorry, David. It looks like you picked the wrong girl.
Well, look at you, the little innocent pregnant mum.
Well, I hope the magistrate feels the same way.
Oh, he's sure to. You look so serene and lovely. He'll take one look at you and you'll be out of there before you can say jackknife.
Yeah, don't forget to keep in touch and let us know how you are.
Seems sort of sad that you're leaving. I was looking forward to having a little new baby around the place. They're so cuddly. They hold on to you and, oh, they smell so sweet.
We'll come and visit you, Lizzie.
Will you, love?
Yeah.
He can pretend that I'm his grandma.
Oh, come on. You'll be lucky to even get one look at it, let alone take it visiting.
Ready, Bradshaw?
Ready.
Good luck, Roxy.
Goodbye, love.
Bye, all.
Bye.
See ya.
You know, Lizzie, I'm really gonna miss her.
Yeah, well, I'm not. Anybody would sell their babies pretty low in my book.
Thanks, Joe.
Oh, I went to see young Jill Coulson this morning. She took the news very badly.
Poor child. Losing both parents so close together. It's very good of you to go and see her. Not an easy thing to do.
She kept remembering her visit here. She thinks her mother killed herself because she thought that Jill didn't love her anymore. And the hardest thing was walking away and leaving the kid in that welfare home.
Well, that's one thing you don't have to worry about anymore. I've just been on the phone to the welfare department. They contacted Coulson's sister again. Now that Carol's gone, they've reassessed their situation and they've decided they will take Jill after all.
Good.
Roxanne Valerie Bradshaw. This court has found you guilty of handling stolen goods. I've taken into consideration your learned counsel's plea as to your determination to reform and also your present physical condition. However, I have a duty to the community as well as to the law, and it is this court's decision, therefore, that you will be imprisoned for a period of 6 months.
No!
I'm sorry, what did you say your name was again?
Watson. James Watson.
Right, Mr. Watson. Now, what is it that's so important that you can't tell me at the door?
Well, I have reason to believe that my wife is staying here.
Your
and
wife?
Yes, Pixie.
Pixie Watson?
That's right.
Well, I'm sorry, you've been given a bum steer. There's nobody by that name staying here. You even got a picture of her or something, have you?
Oh, yes, I have.
This is your wife?
Yes. Don't know why she ran away from me. Probably something I said. I just want to talk to her.
Well, you wait here. I might be able to help you after all.
Oh, thank you.
Hello, Wally.
Afternoon, Governor.
All ready for the next session?
I am, as a matter of fact. Only hope the women are too.
Oh, I'm sure they are. Anything to break the monotony.
Oh, thanks a lot.
Oh, sorry. I didn't mean it like that. By the way, I had another look at that attic flat at our place. I think it'd be ideal for you.
I suppose so, but after living up in the hills, I'm not very excited at the prospect of living in a shoebox.
Oh, it's not a shoebox. And we've got a few odd bits and pieces you can have that'll make it really comfortable. Anyway, you've got to have somewhere to stay in the city, haven't you?
Pixie!
James! Oh, hello!
Well, I see you do recognise
him. Oh, yes. Judy, this is my husband, James.
Yes, we've met. But it's funny, I would have never picked him as your husband. That's not how you described him at all.
Yes, this is my husband, all right.
Well, I'll let you two lovebirds alone for a while. But later on, I want to have a talk with you, Pixie.
Darling, are you all right? I've been so worried about you.
Oh, I'm fine. I'm sorry I ran out on you like that, but, well, I just needed to get away by myself for a while.
Well, this is Hardly by yourself.
Oh, you know what I mean.
What did I do, Pixie? Did I say something that upset you?
No, James, it wasn't you. It was me. Well, it was us.
Us?
Yes, it just wasn't working out. I love you, James, but it was our life together. Living in that awful little flat. I had nothing to do all day and you were always out working.
But I have to work. I know the job takes up a lot of time, but there's nothing I could do about that. I thought you'd settle down to it after a while and... Well, where do you think the money came from that you took from our account?
Oh, yes, well, I'm sorry I didn't ask you about that, but I was desperate. I had to have some money and... Well, you wouldn't want to see me walking around destitute, would you?
Oh, of course, I'm not worried about the money. I just want you to be happy.
You don't want it back?
Of course not. You must have needed it or you wouldn't have taken it.
Oh, James, you see, that's the problem. You're too nice. And I know me, I'm never going to change.
You're trying to say it's over, aren't you? Well, it's not really a surprise. I always knew I'd never be able to hold on to you. I'm not exciting enough, I suppose.
Oh, don't say that, James. It's not your fault, it's mine. I'm not mature enough for you.
Well, I won't bother you again. I think that's best, don't you?
Going back to the office?
Yes, I suppose so.
Would you mind terribly dropping me off at a friend's place?
Of course not.
Oh, thanks. I'll just go and get my hat on my back. I won't be a dick.
Not exactly Christine Dior, is it?
No. Oh, well, you don't look too bad.
Probably just as well we haven't got a full-length mirror. Suppose I look like a circus tent.
You feeling all right?
Oh, fair enough.
All right. Just remember, the governor said you don't have to work if you don't want to.
Poor little bugger. Not much of a start, is it, being born in a prison?
Oh, I don't know. That's how I came into the world.
I'm going to miss you, Pixie. I still love you.
Oh, and I love you, James. You're a really nice man. But I know you'd be better off without me. I don't want to hurt you anymore. Now just drive off and don't look back. Goodbye. Oh, Philip.
Hello, darling. Who was the guy in the car?
Oh, a friend. An ex-friend, actually.
Just as well. Right. You ready for a big surprise?
What?
Our new home. I've just bought it.
Oh, Philip, it's beautiful. Do you mean it?
Sure do. Have to look after the future Mrs. Farnham, don't I?
Oh, darling.
Well, that's very interesting. What's it supposed to be?
It's going to be a ladder.
Ah, that's the idea, Lizzie. Now, look, if you smooth the sides down, it won't look so much like a curled-up snake.
It is a bloody curled-up snake.
It's a very good one. Brandy, what's the matter? Can't you think of anything to make?
Can't do this sort of thing.
Oh, yes, you can. Why don't you try making an animal, a pig or a horse?
No, I said I can't. I don't want to.
Roxy, what are you doing back here?
Oh, good, love, I didn't expect to see you back in here again.
Oh, I did. How long did you get?
6 months.
6 months? That means your baby's going to be born in here.
Yeah, it's a real drag.
All right, ladies, let's not disrupt Wally's class. Roxanne, why don't you try making something?
Don't you think I've been doing enough of that lately? Oops, I think she heard me.
Oh, I see. It's become a she, has it?
All right, come on, back to the modelling.
This car's shaping up.
How does it look?